Hi, today we will see about the queue data structure. Everybody know the meaning for the queue. In general, for example, if you take one shop, if you want to purchase something from the shop, then if there is a queue, whoever is standing in the queue first, they will get the product first. Whoever is standing at the last, they will get the product the last. So the queue is following this rule: first in, first out. Or you can say last in, last out. Whoever is in the first, they will get the product at first. That same rule will be followed here in the queue data structure also. It is a linear data structure in which where the insertion and deletion operations are performed in two different ends. We are telling that front and last end. Front end or last end or rear end, you can tell. It is a rear end. So the insertion will be performed at the end of the end, and the deletion will be performed at the another end. Means insertion will be done at one end and the deletion will be done at the another end. So insertion will be done in which end? If you just think about the queue, whoever is in the first, that person will be coming out. So that we are telling that is a deletion operation here. And whoever is coming and joining the queue at the last, that operation we are telling it as an insertion. According to the data structure, we are telling whoever is joining the queue at the last, that we are telling it as an insertion. Whoever is joining, that joining people, we have to consider it as a data. So whoever is joining at the last, that will be the insertion, and whoever is coming out of the queue, that we are telling it as a deletion operation. So the deletion operation will be performed in the front end and the insertion will be done in the rear end. So these two points you have to keep in mind. For example, I have given one animation here. If you see, the data is coming and joining. This is the insertion point in the data structure. Whoever is coming out from the queue, this is called a deletion. For example, just I have shown one animation. Okay, so here there are two queues, just to see one queue only. So this will be the inserting data, and which is going out of the data will be the deletion of the data. So keep in mind, so whichever data is going in first, that data will be coming out of the queue first. So you should follow the rule of first in, first out, or last in, last out. Okay, so insertion and deletion operation will be performed according to the rule of first in, first out principle. So just to consider this as a queue, and this will be the front end and this will be the rear end. If this will be the front end, then here the deletion operation will be performed, here the insertion operation will be performed. So there are two functions which is used to do the deletion and the insertion operation. The operation of insertion will be performed with the function of NQ. Similarly, for the DQ, for deleting the elements, if you give the function DQ, it automatically deletes the data which is at the front over here. NQ operation, you have to give the data which you have to insert at the rear end here. Inside the function, you have to give the data. So, Q data structure will be implemented in two methods. One is using array and another one is using linked list. You can implement the data according to your requirement. If you have the queue data fixed, then you can go for the array. In case if you have only 100 number of elements, you want to create it as a queue, then you can go for the array. So it is for only the limited number of elements. Linked list is for unlimited number of elements. In that case, you can use the linked list. Here I have given some diagram to understand the NQ operation. Just consider this as a queue. This queue having A, B, C as the elements. If you want to insert the data D here, you have to insert it in the rear end. This is the front end, this is the rear end. So in NQ operation will be performed at the rear end. So this D will be added after the C. Okay, so once you have inserted, the list will be like this. The enqueued queue will be like this. If you want to delete the data from this, by default A will be deleted. If you give the DQ operation, automatically the front element will be deleted because the queue is following first in first out. As per first in first out, A is the first element which has entered at first, it will be deleted first. So DQ operation, if you give the DQ operation, the front end will be deleted, so A will be deleted. Once it is deleted, the queue will be like this. If you want to create the queue using linked list, you have to create like this. Already you know what is linked list and how to create the linked list. So only you should remember that deletion and insertion, how you to do it in case of queue linked using linked list. So in case of queue using linked list, the front end head will be used for deletion and the rear end, that final element, will be used for insertion. Okay, so this null pointer will represent the data which is going to be inserted in further. Hope you understand what is linked list, what is queue and how it will be implemented using array and linked list. If you have doubts, you can do comment. Thank you. In next video, we will see about stack.